Dear students, I am Mary Ganilam from Bharat Institute of Law, Assistant Professor of Law, Bharat Institute of Higher Education and Research. Today we are going to see something about maintenance of wife, children and parents from Criminal Procedure Code. As per Chapter 19 of the Criminal Procedure Code, the Criminal Code has the power to order maintenance of wife, children and parents. Section 125 to 128 of the Criminal Procedure Code speaks about that order of maintenance to wife, children and parents. Section 125, which discuss about that order for maintenance of wife, children and parents. If any person having sufficient means neglects or refuses to maintain his wife, his legitimate and illegitimate children and his parents, then they are all eligible to file a criminal case regarding asking about that maintenance. A common man having some kind of sufficient means and he voluntarily willingly neglect or refuses to maintain his wife as well as his legitimate as well as that illegitimate children. Whether it may be an illegitimate child, he has the right to property as well as a right to claim maintenance. As per Section 125, the illegitimate child also having the right to claim maintenance from his father or her father. So a dutiful man has the duty to maintain his wife's children as well as the aged parents. So if he has sufficient means and voluntarily he has neglect to do certain duty to maintain all those things, he is liable to give such kind of maintenance amount to his children, wife as well as that parent. So here wife as well as legitimate, illegitimate children. Here, legitimate and illegitimate children means they are minor children as well as if they attained majority but they are not able to maintain themselves and that aspect also they are claiming maintenance from his father or her father. So the illegitimate children or the legitimate children, they attained majority and that aspect also they can claim maintenance from their father. So a man has a duty to maintain his legitimate as well as that illegitimate children and also the father or mother of the person. A dutiful son has the duty to maintain his father as well as mother. So if any wife or children or parent are not able to maintain themselves, they can file a case before the criminal court under section 125 CRPC for claiming maintenance. So next time we should know something about here. They mentioned about minor children. Minor in the sense means as per Indian Majority Act, the children, those who are all not attained 18 years is called as a minor children. So as per children, if they attained majority, they also claim maintenance due to reason, some kind of mentally not at all stable persons as well as not physically able to maintain themselves, they also can claim maintenance from their parent, their father. So here minor means as per Indian Majority Act, those who are all not attained 18 years, they are called as a minor as well as wife. Here wife includes not only a wife is means as per law, he may be a divorced one until they get remarried. Sometimes the wife got some kind of divorce from the husband, but she is still not at all getting some remarriage. She also claimed maintenance from the husband. So until remarriage, she, that particular husband also called as a dutiful husband, he has to maintain his wife. So until remarriage, she also claimed maintenance from the husband. So wife includes who has been divorced by or has obtained a divorce from her husband and has not remarried. So here we should know something about them, where we will file the petition, and the order is pronounced from which date to which date. That's the important thing, because we file a criminal case as a MC case filed before the criminal court, and the order may be pronounced from the date of the petition or from the date of the from the date of the order. So it may be based on the court. The court may decide whether the maintenance amount may be given at a time from the date of petition or from the date of the order. So, and also in the maintenance case, the court may give such kind of expenses spent by the wife at the time of criminal case. It may be advocate fees or any kind of drafting fees, all those things which are included in the expenses of proceedings. So at the time of maintenance case, they are claiming such kind of expenses also. Here the expenses means expenses spent for the case, that took maintenance case. The court may consider that particular details also. Based on that, that court may provide how much that amount, the quantity of amount will be decided by the court. Next thing we should know, if suppose that 125 CRPC order is not at all followed by the dutiful husband or dutiful father or dutiful son, the court may issue warrant to for arrest of that person. Court may issue warrant, otherwise court may attach some kind of property of that person. That that warrant, through that warrant, the person may be arrested for 1 month or until that payment of that amount. So initial period of imprisonment may be given to that person who is not at all maintain his wife, children and parent. So as per that section 125 order, if any person is not at all obeyed his duty or not at all giving such maintenance amount monthly to monthly, and that aspect, that person has to face some kind of legal consequences. Here the legal consequences in the sense means imprisonment. So next we should know, sometimes the wife is not at all entitled to get some kind of maintenance amount. For on what reasons and what aspect the wife is not entitled to get that maintenance amount? So first, if she is living in adultery relationship, the wife is living with some other person, we all know like adultery is a punishable offense as per IPC, but now it is permissible one. But as per section 125, if any woman is living with, or any man is living with a married woman, and that aspect, the woman is not at all eligible to get or eligible to file a maintenance case before the criminal court under section 125 CRPC. As well as, if any woman has sufficient means to maintain herself in the sense means, she is not at all eligible to, or he is not at all file a case under section 125. If nowadays all the women are going to job and getting sufficient amount to maintain themselves in the sense means, they are not at all getting not at all file a case before the criminal court for claiming this maintenance amount. The main purpose of this 125 is providing some kind of the people, those who are all not at maintain themselves, like food, clothes, shelter, all those things. So initially the object of the provision is to providing some kind of basic necessity to the people, not maintain themselves. Under that aspect only the 125 is added in this criminal procedure code. But the people or the wife is well versed as well as having sufficient means to maintain herself, in the sense means she is not at all eligible to file a case under section 125. And the third important point is, suppose the wife is getting divorced as some getting divorced by mutual consent, and that aspect also the wife is not at all eligible or not at all file a case under section 125 CRPC, because as per mutual consent both the parties themselves agreed, you know, consent given by the both parties, only the divorce is granted by the court. So they may claim some kind of permanent alimony, permanent alimony through that mutual consent, or some kind of settlement happened between the parties at the time of mutual consent. So all those things, whenever the divorce obtained through the mutual consent also, the wife is not at all eligible to file a maintenance case under section 125 CRPC. So next we should know, suppose the wife, having such kind of order, like maintenance order, but the court has the authority to cancel that order. What are the situations this will be happened, in the sense means, whenever the girl, you know, after getting that order, the girl is living in adult relationship, or suppose at the time of order, at the time of order, that girl is not at all having sufficient means to maintain herself. But afterwards, that after getting order of maintenance from the criminal court, she is having some sufficient means, or he is going to a job, or he is going to get some kind of sufficient means, in the sense, in that aspect, that the court may cancel that order. What will be doing from the side of husband, in the sense, they are filing a petition before the court, stating that the wife is going to duty or job, or he has to prove like that wife has sufficient means to maintain herself. The court will decide based on the evidence. The court will come to the conclusion whether the order will be cancelled or not. So next term, in the suspect, the court may, once ordered for maintenance, they can have the power to cancel the order of maintenance. So we cannot say that once the maintenance order passed by the magistrate, it will be cancelled by the court. We cannot say, the court cannot cancel the order. We cannot say like that. The court may cancel based on these conditions. Next, what are the procedures? As per section 126, what are the procedures to be followed by the criminal courts, like magistrate courts or sessions court? Like here, we should know, first they mentioned about section 126 class 1, that the criminal procedure code mentioned about the jurisdiction of the, jurisdiction of the criminal courts for section 125. That means the maintenance case filed by the wife before where, or where the maintenance case is going to be filed by the wife. So jurisdiction. So jurisdiction is normally that the matrimonial disputes or this kind of maintenance case, the jurisdiction is always in favor of woman. So the woman can file a case first where he is. That means the husband where he is living or he is working, all those things. And next, where the wife is living or the wife is working. So the second one is the wife. Suppose the wife is residing some other place and residing, working in some other place, in the sense, she has the right to file a case under section 125 before the jurisdiction of that where she is living. Next, third one is like where both the husband and wife are last resided, like at the time of divorce or at a time of marriage, where both the parties are living together, that place also having the jurisdiction to file a criminal case like under section 125 CRPC. So the jurisdiction is always in favor of the woman. The woman has the right to file a criminal case, especially the maintenance case under section 125 CRPC, before any place where the person is, where she is, and where the both parties are living together at last. So next we should know like that maintenance amount, at the time of order, the order will be pronounced to whom? That's an important procedure. Normally, the maintenance case, both the parties should present each and every hearing. That's the concept. But at time of order, who claimed that maintenance, the party should be present at the time of pronouncing the order. Or suppose the party will get some kind of dispense with from the court, in the sense that they may allow, without their presence, the court may order that maintenance order. Otherwise, both the parties, especially the wife or parent or children, should be present at the time of order. Here, the children may be a minor, in the sense means that the guardian will be permitted to be present at the time of pronouncing the maintenance order. Next, section 127, alteration in allowance. Here, once the maintenance case ordered by the criminal court, it can be changed or not. That's an important question. For example, the court may give a certain amount. For example, that maintenance amount has to be given for monthly to monthly. So, Jan to December, they have to pay each and every month certain amounts. So, that amount may be increased or decreased. That's a question which was decided under section 127 of CRPC. So, as per this section, the court can alter the maintenance amount. We cannot say once the amount is fixed, it cannot be altered or modified. We cannot say like that. What are the circumstances on which the maintenance amount can be altered? That's the concept which speaks under section 127. First thing, based on the change of the circumstances of the any person. Here, maybe that the husband's job may be lapsed, or the husband's earnings may be decreased, or the wife may got some kind of job. In that circumstances, the person may apply again or file a petition again before the court, and the court may decide whether the amount may be decreased or the maintenance order may be cancelled. All those things will decide by the court. So, based on the circumstances, the changing circumstances, the amount which was given by the husband may be altered. Next, that the alteration amount also fixed by the magistrate. The amount cannot be fixed by that, alteration amount cannot be fixed by that person. That person of the husband, that person cannot be fixed that amount. Whatever it may be, the maintenance amount is fixed by the discretionary power of the court, and also the alteration amount also fixed by the court. The court may decide. And what aspect they are claiming this altered amount? Not only that alteration is not only that decreasing amount. The wife can also file a petition before the court claiming that extra amount, that increasing amount. So the wife as well as husband both are having the right to file a petition before the criminal courts claiming that alteration of the amount. Whatever it may be, the court may decide whether and what aspect we have to alter that amount. So these are the things. And next we should know, suppose the wife can remarried or maybe having some relationship with some other persons, on that aspect also the court may alter the amount which was already ordered. Next, suppose some wife after that maintenance order, surrender his maintenance right. You know, they may be through getting remarriage, or she may voluntarily herself to surrender the right of claiming maintenance, and that aspect the court may cancel the order of maintenance. The order may be cancelled on the date of the order, not at all retrospective effect. So normally the maintenance order is basically from the date of the application is given by the court, but certain circumstances the order may be passed at the date of the order. So normally that section 125, the initially that maintenance amount which was prescribed by the CRPC is only rupees 500, you know, that maximum amount, because providing some kind of food, clothing or shelter, or basic that providing some kind of fulfilling some kind of basic necessity only, that 125 CRPC is used. But nowadays, based on the changing circumstances and situations, the amount may be increased. So increased here in the sense means the court may prescribe the amount based on the pleadings as well as living conditions of the people and status of the people. The court may fix the amount, how much amount, and what amount they claim, and based on the pleading as well as evidences, how much property the husband having, and how much earnings the husband having, all those things, based on that only the court may prescribe the amount. So maybe, you know, monthly they can, some courts can give monthly 1 lakh until, up to that amount also now providing. Other than that, initially it was fixed as rupees 500 only. The amount is not exceeding 500, but nowadays it's not at all followed, because 500 is not at all used for each and every purpose. So that basic necessity is not fulfilled through this rupees 500. So the amount is nowadays increased. All those things is based on that discretionary power of the court. The court will decide the amount. Next is that enforcement of order of the maintenance. The important thing as per section 128, the order copy of the maintenance is given to the parties immediately without any cost. So free of cost, the order of maintenance is issued to the parties. She may be a wife, children, or parents. So already we know, at the time of order, the party should be present. They may be a parent or a child or a wife. They may be present. In their presence only, the order may be passed by the court, except the dispense with the dispense with. Otherwise, the party should be present at the time of order. So, the order copy must be given to the parties without any cost. That's an important concept. So suppose already I told you that order copy may be given to the guardian of the children, those who are all comes under the cadre of guardian, or comes under that viewing of guardian. The order copy should be given to the children's guardian. So next, already told you the maintenance allowances or expenses of the process should be given at the time of ordering the petition. So final, whenever the maintenance order is followed, is allowed or ordered by the court will consider that expenses also. Here the expenses in the sense means that providing some kind of expenses for proceedings of the case. So magistrate is himself satisfied that identity of the parties, and court can find out the identity as well as through the non payment of the allowance, that free of cost, that order copy should be given to the parties. So normally we have certain provisions in personal laws. Before family court, they have, the parties has the right to file a case as a maintenance case, as a MC case, file before the family court's case, or personal laws case. We have so many things, Hindu Marriage Act, Christian Marriage Act, or Muslims, we have so many personal laws are available. But what is the difference between that maintenance case, this maintenance case, in the sense means, in the personal laws, that maintenance case can filed by the husband as well as the wife. The MC case can filed both the spouse. The wife can file a maintenance case against the husband, and the husband has filed a maintenance case against the wife. It is normally followed in personal laws. But in that criminal case, in that 125 CRPC, that maintenance case is filed only by the wife against husband. The husband cannot claim that maintenance case against the wife in under section 125 CRPC. That's an important thing, which is the difference between that maintenance case before the family courts or any personal laws case, compared with this maintenance case. And both the cases, we have the provisions regarding the attachment. Suppose the maintenance amount is not at all given by the spouse. Like here, under section 125, the husband is not at all given that maintenance amount. The son is not at all giving such maintenance amount to the parent, or not at all maintain his children. And that aspect, the salary or the property of the husband has to be attached by the court. The wife can file a petition regarding the attachment of the property before the court. The court may consider that particular petition, and the court may order attachment of the salary or attachment of the property. So based on that, the court may attach the property and take auction proceedings and sell that property, and automatically certain amounts are taken from the salary of the husband. These are all the provisions, or proceedings are available in that criminal cases also. As well as compared with that personal laws, in criminal maintenance cases, that this cases that up to 1 month imprisonment also provided to the husband. Those who are not at all maintain their children, wife, as well as their parent, they have to face the imprisonment also. Otherwise, it may be extended until they repay, until they pay the amount to the parent or children, or as well as the wives. So compared with personal laws, as well as that this 125 CRPC, the personal laws, we can file a case before the family courts or any courts. We can see that in civil court nature, we can see. But compared with that, this 125 CRPC, we have the provisions regarding maintenance case in criminal courts. So we have certain provisions regarding imprisonment. So once those who are all not at all follow this kind of procedures or proceedings, they have to face the legal consequences. That is, they have to face the imprisonment also. So every husband has the duty, or every son has the duty, and every father has the duty to maintain his wife, children, and parent. We all are known, whether it may be a legal or legitimate or illegitimate children, they are all the right to get a maintenance from their parent. Suppose the children can maintain themselves, in the sense means the maintenance cannot claim from that their child. Until then, one minor children is there, the minor children has eligible or has the right to get maintenance from his father or her father. Suppose minor girl is legitimate or illegitimate children is a daughter in the sense means until get marriage the daughter can claim maintenance from her father. But certain circumstances after that marriage also children, those who are all not maintain themselves, the reason behind is some kind of physically mentally instability, mentally affected person or not able to go to jobs or cannot claim such kind of earning money, in that circumstances they can claim maintenance from the side of father. So such an important concept in CRPC regarding that maintenance of wife, children and parent. So they themselves accept certain terms and conditions, in sense means we cannot claim maintenance against the husband. For example, that divorce get through mutual consent. At the time of divorce, they can claim certain permanent alimony. There is they claimed certain kind of lump sum from the court at the time of divorce. They cannot again claim maintenance from mandri to mandri. They already got certain huge amount from that husband because that amount is fixed at the consent of both the parties. The parties themselves agreed like this amount is sufficient to me, this amount is enough to me. Again, they cannot claim that maintenance amount from the side of the husband. So that is a second thing is which was very important. Once they remarried, they cannot claim that amount. Because here the wife includes, she may be divorced from her husband. But again, until she gets remarried, she can claim the amount. Suppose if she cannot marry again, or again she married, in the sense means the court can cancel that order. Again, otherwise the she herself, she is herself accepted that cancellation of that maintenance. Otherwise, the husband file a petition before that court, claiming that alteration amount or cancel that amount, all those things. So against that maintenance case order, the parties has the right to file a execution petition before the court. Through that execution petition, they can claim attachment as well as that imprisonment may also can claim regarding this maintenance order. So in criminal courts also having the right to giving maintenance to wife, children and parent, that is speaks about section 120 5 to 128 CRPC. So we should completely know that the amount, the quantity of amount, we cannot fixed. He may be she, the girl or the boy, husband or wife, they cannot come to the conclusion this much amount I'm going to give or this much amount I'm going to get. That both the parties cannot claim, cannot fix, because the amount is based on that situations of pleadings as well as the living conditions or the living nature of that parties or status of the parties. Discretionary power is important thing in that section 125 concept, because section 125 the amount is based on the discretionary power. The court will fix the amount based on the evidence as well as that facts and circumstances. So it's very useful to the parties as well as that wives, children, all those things. And big thing is that each man has the duty to maintain his wife, children as well as the parent. The aged parent is having the right to get maintenance from their son. So the son is a important part because they are having the duty to maintain his or his parents. So that at the time of age situations, they can get maintenance from the son through these things. So free of cost, that order will be provided to the parties. Through that copy, the parties can file a execution petition. Through that execution petition, they can enforce that order of maintenance. So then that's an important topic for the one of the important topic in criminal procedure code. Thank you. We'll see it in next concept or topic in criminal procedure code. Thank you.